Awesome. Mr. Mutizwa, and thanks again for traveling all this distance and for rearranging your schedule because of we rearranged ours. Thank you.
Chairman Fleck, members of the committee, I thank you very much for inviting me to make this presentation today. I was most privileged in April this year to have the opportunity to meet Senator Fleck and Senator Coons and members of the committee in Zimbabwe. I'm here as a representative of the Zimbabwe private sector, which for long has been an absent partner in this process. We have not had the opportunity to have our voices heard in this committee. I'm here not as a politician. I'm not a politician. I'm a businessman. I lead the 63 members of the Zimbabwe Stock Exchange Listed Companies Forum, which are the bulk of the private sector in Zimbabwe. Mr. Chairman, fellow members of the committee, I have already deposited my written submission, which is quite substantial. Not being familiar with the proceedings here, I will summarize kind of my remarks over and above the submission I've already made. I would like first to paint the picture in Zimbabwe as we see it from the private sector point of view. First of all, and very critical to us, Zimbabwe has embarked on a difficult and very painful road of transformation. For the first time in 38 years, Zimbabweans can express themselves freely. It was unheard of to experience the kind of freedom of expression that we see in Zimbabwe today during the time of Robert Mugabe. But what we observe, Mr. Chairman, is that there's a crisis of expectations. People, having been in bondage for 38 years, now want everything today. There's a